Hey all, my name is Lauren, and today I am super excited to talk to you about code layers. So at Config 2025 this year, we released Figma Make, which is an AI tool that Figma created to help you turn existing designs into working prototypes or create functional web apps and prototypes completely from scratch. Now, code layers is letting us bring that functionality of Make right into Figma Sites. Now, first things first, what exactly is the difference? So while Figma Make is really more so focused on full web apps, so either starting completely from scratch or bringing in a design that you can then prototype, it's really about the entire app itself. Versus code layers is really focusing on those individual layers within your sites and adding functionality, adding things like animation to those specific layers and adding on things that you might not be able to achieve otherwise with just our default interactions. So let's get into it. I'm going to start from scratch using one of our templates, and I'm going to go into the business section and grab the Sweet Flower Shop. And this is something that you can grab right from Figma Sites yourself too, so you can follow along. Now, before we actually get into the code layers, I wanted to note that you can make a lot of things interactive without using that. So for example, we can use some preset interactions, maybe on this section right here. I want to go to interactions right over here and make this reveal as it fades in about 200 milliseconds afterwards, and say maybe on this little banner right here, I want this to have a hover effect so that when I hover it over, it scales up. Great. If we play that with our inline preview, we can see that this faded in and this has a nice hover there. And that's great, but I want a little bit more. I want to see how I can really enhance these interactions. So what I'm going to do is create a code layer. And when we create code layers, we can either do it completely from scratch or we can start from previously created designs. I'm going to start this one from scratch, and I'm going to do that by pressing E on my keyboard and pulling out a layer right here. You'll see when I do that, this modal pops up, and here's where I'm able to describe what I want to do. So I'm going to say create floral confetti that spans the width of the layer using flower emojis. So you can see it's starting to figure out the reasoning here. Once it does that, it'll actually start creating the code. And if I go into split view, I can see that code being created live. Awesome. And now we have our confetti here. Now, a couple things to note. We can see right here that I have some properties created. And let's take a look at this in just the chat so that we can see it a little bit bigger. I can edit these properties right here. I can change the speed. Let's make it go a little bit faster. And we obviously want to show the confetti because that was the whole point. So we'll keep that. And maybe I want a lot more. Let's change this to 100. That'll add a ton more confetti here. I can see those properties right here. I can also see them in my side panel. And you'll also note that I can connect a variable here if I wanted to. So for example, if in my designs I had a variable, let's create a number, and we'll name that. Let's see, this will be 25, my number. If I go back into my code layers here, I can attach this variable to my number here, and that should now show 25 little flowers popping all down. Now, these are looking like I want it to look, but it seems like it's only sticking at the very top of the screen, so I'm actually going to ask for changes here. I'm going to ask it to make the flowers fall down the entire length of the layer. And while this is doing this, I don't have to stay in this console. I can pop out. I can duplicate this if I wanted to edit this as another version right here. So I have multiple versions going on. I can play around with other designs that I have going on. And all the things are still happening in the background. So if I pop back into the edit code, I can see what it's doing. And that's looking a lot better. That's much more how I want it to be, falling down all the way. So I'm going to add this as a layer. I'm going to add this on top of my sites right here. We're going to pop it in here. We're going to go to absolute positioning so it can be right on top of everything. And we're just moving it up a little bit. And I'm going to shrink it a little bit. And you can see this is all happening across the screens because multi-edit's turned on. If I want to shrink it down a little bit for each size, we can do that too. And then we're going to check it out, see how it looks in our preview. Let's go to our big one here. And now we have flowers. Great. Amazing. We have our floral confetti. But what I'm starting to think is I want a little bit more. I kind of have this vision in my head of exactly what I want. I don't quite want emojis. They don't go with the entire look of it. It was a great start, but I want to be able to start with designs that I already have so I can be a little bit more specific. And for that, we are going to use code layers, but we're going to start with our designs. So for example, let's pop into another file that we have here. Say I want these specific flowers as my confetti. And instead of really confetti, I want them just to kind of like grow as if they're like growing up from a garden every time I hover over. So I just created a grid of flowers right here. And I am going to go ahead and in interactions, I'm going to say make interactive with code. Same modal pops up here, but it's looking slightly different. It's not giving me a prompt here. And my designs are showing up here because that's what I want to start with. So what I'm going to say is make all the images hidden by default. And then when I hover over them, make them subtly appear and bounce. And then when I leave the image, make it disappear again. There's nothing harder than trying to type with people watching you. Okay, let's do that. Again, we're gonna let that go. It's gonna kind of figure out what it wants to do. It's thinking, it's gonna reason. We can have the split screen open. It's got some code right here already of what I have for my designs, and then it will start doing its thing. Now, while that thinks, let's go check out one that I have pre-created. So I have same prompt in there. I've got my these flowers, and when I check this out in our preview, we have our flowers here, and as I kind of hover over, hope you enjoy my sound effects. This is pretty fun. Now, I could probably figure out how to do this similar effect with the preset interactions that we have, but it would take a while and there would be a lot of thought that I would have to go into it, but it could still potentially be done. So let's get into an even more complicated example that we really couldn't do with just the preset interactions. Let's check out this right here. So on my floral site, I want the option to be able to create a custom floral arrangement. I want this DIY option where essentially customers can just come to my site, they can do their floral arrangement, drag out all these flowers, see how they look together, and then hit head to checkout, and then I'll put those flowers together for them. Great. Now, if I was using the preset interactions, I could go right here. I could say draggable. So I've made this one draggable right here. But when I go to check this out, the trouble is I can drag this out, but A, we've lost it. And I'm pretty sure that's because this is a frame right here. So now it's gone beyond the bounds of the frame and I can't find it. So that's tricky. And also what I really wanted is I want those flowers to stay there the whole time. I want to be dragging out copies, and we're not able to drag out copies in those preset interactions that we have. So let's get into how code layers can make this possible. We're going to go ahead and pop in here. I'm actually going to take this off. And again, we're going to go to make interactive with code. So we can see when I'm in here again, it's got my designs here, but I'm going to go ahead and put my prompt into here. And we're going to copy paste this one because it's a longer one. So I want to create a DIY floral bouquet arrangement. On the right side, I have 6 flower options, and I want to be able to drag and drop a copy of each of those flowers as many times as I want anywhere on the canvas. And the copy of the flowers should be the exact same size as the original flower, and otherwise the design shouldn't be altered. Again, we're going to go ahead, press start, check out our split view as it's thinking, and see what it comes up with. Again, it shows us our reasoning here, what it wants to do, and then it's going to start going. So as that's going, let's check out another pre-created one. And we'll pop right into here and do edit code to see what we've got. Now, this one we can see was a little bit more complicated than our other ones that we have. We have had a couple of prompts going into here. And we started out with the same prompt right here. And some of these prompts was me asking, okay, it's not quite what I wanted. I can't see the original images, so let's fix that. But a good amount of the things too were me realizing, okay, I actually want to add on in addition to the designs that I already had. So at a certain point, I got it working just like I wanted to. I was able to drag out a copy right here. Perfect. I'm able to start creating this nice little floral arrangement. But in my original prompt, I never said anything about rotating, but you can see here, I'm able to rotate and bring to front and to back. So at a certain point, I was like, let's add that into the designs. So if we head down, that was my next prompt here. Great. let's rotate everything by 5 degrees and allow me to bring it to front and back. Because for example, if I pop this one in here and I said, actually, I want this kind of these leaves behind the flowers, I want to be able to push that to the back and move these things around and rotate. And then we're going to put some poppies in here. Another thing that I realized along the way was, okay, this is cute, but what if I have regrets? What if I decide, okay, I don't want this flower anymore. It doesn't really match. How do I get rid of that? So again, I prompted to add a way to add a button that will remove the most recent flower added and a button that will reset all the changes to remove all the flower copies. So if I did undo, there we go. We can get rid of that. Or I can again say, eh, that's not great. So this is working really, really well. One thing I even decided at the end was that this vase was a little bit too high up in the original designs that I had created. So what I did was focused specifically on one div here. So I clicked on that. You can see it's kind of highlighting it right here. And I asked it to move it down 35 pixels, which was really helpful. Another thing we can do with that selection tool specifically is we could go in and we could edit things right on this canvas right here. I could edit the color. Maybe I actually want this to be kind of a darker gray here. And if we're feeling really wild, we can even get into the code. So if we go to the split view and we see our code here, now I'm no coder, which is probably very clear by the fact that I just called it a coder and not a developer. But what I can do, at least I'm going to make this a little bit bigger for myself, is check in here and I can start to understand things even though I'm not a developer. So if I look in here, I can see that we have width and height of 16. What if I want to make this a little bit bigger? I can actually change the code here. We're going to change that to 32. We're going to change that to 32 so that my button size is a little bit bigger here. I'm going to do the same thing on my other button, on my undo button. We're going to change that to 32 and again, 32. So I can get right in with the code here and edit the code. And just like how Figma is multiplayer, you can even have your developers jump in here and get a little bit more in depth too. Now, let's talk about these designs. I obviously changed up a little bit from my original designs, and that's not a problem at all. I kind of like the way it actually ended. But what if I want my designs back? Like I cannot edit other than right in here, other than in my now code layers, I can't edit this as actual layers as I had originally. So there is a solution to that. I can select this and go right up to these three dots on my right-hand panel, and I can say copy out original design. Now I'll still have this original design here for if I want to play around with this, say I want to make another different total iteration of these designs before I get into code layers, I can do that. Or if I really feel like, okay, this went way too far away from my designs, I just want to start again, I can also say restore original designs. That gets rid of the code altogether. And now we're just back to our original designs. Now also, if I decided maybe actually something like the confetti, let's go back to our confetti example. So we have confetti over here. Say I want this confetti in multiple different locations. Just like in Figma Design, I can make this a component. So I'm going to actually drag this out. And I'm going to go ahead and say make this a component. And now I can use instances of this confetti in different places. So say I want this on top of this bottom image right here as well. Again, we'll switch it to absolute. We'll put it right on top of here. And now we have confetti in multiple different locations on our screen. And if I wanted to edit the original component, boop. We'll go into our code instance. We're just going to lock this so that we can better get this. I'll double click and then this will take me, show me my code instance, and then I can go ahead and edit main component where I have my original component here. Excellent. Hopefully that's helpful in helping you understand code layers a little bit better, and I hope you have fun with it. See you soon.